Well, look, man, Davion Mitchell, was able to get him on the podcast, and I wanted to do it live from our store with me and my wife, Charlene's Beauty Supply here in Elk Grove, and he came through, man. He came through, and he was, you know, it was a podcast that was very informative, man. He had a lot of great stories to tell, a lot of stories that he's never told before. And he was just good, man. He was good with the fans that came out, man. He was taking pictures, signing autographs, man. He's just engaging. So it was cool, man. But this was our way of, like, kind of trying to give back and also show the community that we're here.
Yeah, no, it was. I enjoyed it, man. It was kind of did it for Chris's wife, building a store, black-owned store, and I enjoy it because I kind of need my hair done too. So just to have people with connections like that will help me out in the long run. I mean, just try to help people out. I mean, like you said, a lot of people can't get to games. So I mean, if I can just show my face and be around people as much as I can, as far as just instead of on the basketball court, showing people who I am, who I really am off the court, I think they're kind of more enjoy it than just being on the court.
I'm new, the store is new, so we're trying to show people that we're out here, and this was a way to, like, kind of get the community, to get their eyes and get them to come in here, and it was a good turnout, man. I'm glad everything worked out. We did this pod a few days before free agency starts, which is one of my most hectic times of the year in this NBA field. So I'm glad we got it done now. Look at you got my brother Lance Woods out here, one of the most top-notch comedian of Sacramento, man. What? Hey, but listen, man, that's one thing we want people to see. This, wings are not just for the women. Right. It's for the men, too. Right. We got them for everybody, man. So Charlene's Beauty Supply, come get your cop.
I mean, honestly, yeah, it's a really good store, a store that I'm definitely going to come to as far as getting my hair product stuff. I mean, because I got a lot of hair, so I got to deal with that. I mean, I didn't really know what to expect coming in, but I enjoyed it. I enjoyed the store. I enjoyed the people that came here, the people around the store, people across the street came and said what's up and came to show their face. So I enjoyed it. It's a well-rounded community.
This is my wife's project. This is what she's been wanting to do for a while. And me being an NBA reporter, I'm always on the road. And so for the last 13 years, she's had to carry the load at the house watching the kids. And so now as a husband, I get to try to support her as she tries to, you know, make this thing, you know, make this thing into something really big. And I think she's on her way of doing that.
He's my boss. He bosses me around all the time. So his nickname is Boss. And so I have to make sure I turn the light on and I hurry up and run and do everything before he comes, because he'll be like, you got to do this. So, yeah. Yeah.
Accurate.
Pretty accurate.
Yes, this is my boss. We have hair for every curl or straight hair person, and we have, you know, little trinkets, things for kids, men, women, everything you need to stay beautiful.
And I often say, Sean, that for men and women, our slogan for men and women, don't leave without getting your weave.
It's hard for me because
we still haven't really done a grand opening, but, you know, I think one thing that we're kind of encouraged by is just the support we've been getting in the community so far. Like, people usually, when they tend to get their hair products, they have to go cross town. Right. And so there's a lot of people in the Elk Grove area, even South Sac, they're like, well, we're happy we don't have to go that far. You know, we're not a big store. Mm-hmm. So we opened up with what we have. And so what we're doing is asking the customers who have been coming regularly, like, What is it that you do use, or what it is that you want, mm-hmm, on a day-to-day basis, so we can try to get that for you. So, yeah. You know, we're trying to be there for the community. My wife is doing a good job. She's the face of it. I'm just trying to support her.
Is there something you can reveal here that would be interesting content as far as storytelling goes?
It has to be funny.
It's a little awkward, you know. You don't necessarily mix sports with a beauty supply store, you know. So,
hey, everyone, there's a lot of cool, like, everyone has hair in the NBA or their ball.
For sure.
So you're using beard conditioner, you're using cream.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
I mean,
but it's just,
it's a mesh.
Yeah, it is. But you usually don't see a sports talk podcast with you know, wigs in the background and stuff like that.
Well, now you do.
Welcome
to Charlotte.
We're going to continue to do events like this. I got Damian Lillard coming at some point in this offseason. So I know he's not from here, Sacramento, right, but Sacramento, y'all are like a cousin to the Bay Area. And so, I encourage people to stay tuned for that and come out, man. It's a good community. Like, we're in the shopping center right here with Dollar Tree, Le Beau right here in Elk Grove. Like, it's a good crowd. It's a real good family atmosphere, even amongst the other businesses around here. Mm-hmm. So I encourage everybody to come out and check us out.